everyone, welcome back to another week on the Brush by Brandy YouTube channel. This week we're working on this piece behind me, and you are not seeing double. This is a mirror. So I'm going to give you guys some of my best tips and tricks on making over a mirror. We all get a ton of these with a lot of the dressers that we pick up, and sometimes they're not always useful. Customers either don't want them, so I always end up with a big stash of these mirrors. Well, I actually have someone who wants a dresser mirror, and it just so happens I had the perfect one. So this is a pretty large mirror. We're going to add some interest to it using wood you bed moldings, as you guys can see behind me. We're going to do a beautiful paint finish on this that involves some metallics. And then, of course, some of my best tips about painting around glass. So you guys stick around. Let's take this mirror, this old dated dresser mirror, and make it something really special. Let's get started. Here's where I started on this dresser mirror. It's fairly plain and simple. I definitely need to add some decoration to it. I'm going to start by giving it a good cleaning, and I enlisted a little bit of help on this one. I'm making over this mirror for a customer, and she already has a matching dresser from me. And I added a whole lot of would you bend moldings to the dresser. So we want to make this mirror look like a natural match. So I'm going to take and I'm going to add these guys from would you bend. This is would you bend number WUB2093. And I'm going to unwrap these and we're going to add these moldings to the corners of this mirror, all four corners of it. So I like these because they fit nicely into that 90 degree angle. And it's going to make this mirror look way more ornate than it already is. Once my moldings are open, I'm going to heat these up using my heat gun. Sometimes I also like to put these on a griddle. That'll heat them nice and evenly. In this case, I'm just going to use the heat gun. And then I'm going to apply some adhesive to the back of them. I'm using titebond quick and thick adhesive. I want to make sure I've got a nice even coat of my adhesive over the back of my molding. And so once I do, I'm going to spread it out using my finger. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply the molding to my mirror frame. When I seat the molding into my mirror frame, it does have a tendency to push out some of the glue. So I just use an old artist brush and I clean up some of that glue. And then I'm going to reheat it one more time just to seat that molding perfectly using my heat gun. Would you bend moldings start out rigid, but once you heat them, they do soften and you can mold them into any shape that you like. So this is a fairly flat surface, but there is no such thing as a perfectly flat surface. So heating it allows it to seat perfectly into the shape of this mirror. I love that when I'm done, they look like a natural part of the original piece. You can't tell that they were added later. I'm going to repeat the same process with this medallion at the very top of my mirror. I'm using this medallion because this matches one that I used on the dresser, so it will tie in perfectly. I start off again by heating my medallion, then applying a little bit of my titebond quick and thick adhesive. I'm going to clean up my excess glue and heat it again to get them seated perfectly. Here's my mirror once all of my medallions are added. Notice my handsome photographer. He's doing a great job, you guys. I'm going to go ahead and put on a coat of primer on this one. I'm using Wyzel primer in light gray, and that's just because I plan to use white on this mirror, and I want to make sure that I don't have any bleed through over time that causes discoloration in my paint. Here's what my mirror looks like with all my medallions added and my coat of primer. Let's get started adding some paint to this one. Now that my primer is nice and dry, the colors that I'm using on this are a white and a soft beige. I'm going to be adding some metallic over the beige later, but I need to make the beige as my base for my metallic. I'm going to frame out all of my moldings using the beige color and then blend it softly into the white that's going to go all the way around the frame of the mirror. I repeat this process on every molding, giving it a coat of my beige and then blending it into the white surrounding areas. I'm applying all of my paint using my Klingon brushes. This is the Klingon S50. And on this coat, this is just my base coat. So my blends don't have to be perfect, but I do try to kind of blend the paints into each other. I do like this paint a lot. It's very friendly to blending. I love the color selection. She did an amazing job choosing colors for the line. And these two soft colors are really a nice, easy blend to work together.
Thank you. Here is my mirror with my base coat of paint all the way around. It's already really pretty.
For this mirror project, I'm going to be blending Lilly Moon paint in a shade of white. And then I'm going to be using Modern Masters Metallics. And I've got a base of my paint here. So underneath, I've got Lilly Moon paint. And this color is called Cozy Latte, which is going to be the perfect base for my metallic paint because they're very similar in color. So I've got this in my as my base, and that blends into my white. But now I'm going to turn this into my metallic. I'm going to be using Klingon brushes. This is my F40, which is quickly becoming one of my favorite sizes. And then I'm going to be using my S50 and then their round premium brush from Wise Owl. These are the three brushes I'm going to be using, and they're becoming my most used brushes. I'm going to start out by adding some of my metallic into the details of this corner, and you can see what a close match that is to that cozy latte that's underneath. It really is the perfect base for this metallic. I'm going to use a little mist of water, add my white paint, when I'm painting a mirror, I do paint right onto the glass, and I'll show you guys at the end how I go back and I clean off that glass. So I'm going to surround my molded detail in my clean white paint, and then once those are on there, I'm going to brush that metallic into the white. Once I've overbrushed the molding, I'm just going to use my dry clean brush, and I'm going to blend those together. And that is how I'm going to blend this metallic into my flat white chalk paint and get these metallic corners that blend softly into my white.
Here's my corner with that metallic added. You can see the nice soft sheen that it leaves behind. But we're not done with these moldings yet. I'm going to go ahead and add some glaze. This is an antiquing glaze from Valspar. I'm going to brush it into all of the crevices of my Would You Bend molding, and then I'm going to come back with a dry cloth and I'm going to remove all of the excess glaze from the surface of the molding. Glaze is really this process of applying it and then wiping it back away, and that's going to leave all of the glaze in the recesses of my molding. It's going to really bring out the depth and dimension of this. So here's where I'm using that dry rag, and I'm just wiping away all of the excess from the surface of my molding. I'm getting as much as I can possible with this dry rag. Once I've got as much as I can with the dry rag, I'm going to come back with a wet wipe. In this case, I'm just using cleaning wipes from Costco. Baby wipes also work for this, and I'm just removing all of the rest of the excess glaze from the surface of my molding. I want to still reveal that metallic paint. I don't want to obscure it with the glaze. My final step on these moldings is going to be to decorate them with a little bit of gold gilding wax. This is gold decor wax from Redesign with Prima, and the color is called Eternal. I'm just applying the decor wax using the tip of my finger. I'm dipping it into the little pot of decor wax and then rubbing it over the high points on my molding. I'm not covering the molding completely because I still want to leave some of the paint underneath exposed, so I'm just hitting some of the corners and the outer edges. These photos here are going to show the progression of the molding as it goes from the metallic paint to the glaze and then the gilding wax. You can see what those three layers do together to add some dimension to these moldings. So you remember that I do go ahead and paint onto the glass as I'm painting mirrors? Well, here's the trick. I come back at the very end and I'm going to scrape away all the excess paint just using a razor blade scraper. I know there are all these tips and secrets to painting mirrors that you can shove playing cards in between the mirror and the frame. You can use index cards, all these ways that you can protect your mirror. But I find that just coming back with a razor blade gives me the cleanest edges and I don't have to take the time to tape off the mirror or anything like that. So I'm happiest with the results from just scraping. I went ahead and covered my mirror and sprayed it in clear coat, and this one is done. It is a beautiful piece. Here's the dresser that we were looking to match as well. So what do you guys think? I think we've made a pretty convincing set. You can't tell that these weren't a natural match to begin with. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, you can find links for everything I use in the description for this post. If you did, I hope you'll click that subscribe button, and you can find more Brush by Brandy on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, and on my website at brushbybrandy.com.